Quality silkworm seed is the basic requirement of the sericulture industry. The crop performance and silk productivity are directly related to the quality of seed. Quality silkworm seed refers to the eggs produced from healthy cocoons under optimal environmental conditions. Quality of the seed can deteriorate due to improper handling of the seed during processing, preservation, hibernation, acid treatment, chilling, transportation, incubation, etc. Incubation is one of the most important activities in seed handling to obtain uniform hatching. It has profound influence on volcanism, larval growth and yield as well as quality of cocoons. The term incubation can be defined as preservation of silkworm eggs under optimal environmental conditions, which enables the embryo inside the egg to develop normally so that maximum number of eggs are hatched on the expected day. Egg incubation activity applies especially to those eggs which are naturally active or artificially activated and not to those eggs which are kept under estivation. Silkworm eggs after receiving from greenages must be surface sterilized by dipping in 2% formalin solution for 10 minutes and dried in shade before subjecting to incubation. Incubation of silkworm eggs should be done in a pathogen-free room with a temperature of 25 plus or minus 1 degree centigrade, relative humidity of 75 plus or minus 5%, air current of 0.3 meter per second and photoperiod of 16 hours light and 8 hours darkness per day. The eggs incubated under these conditions hatch in 10 to 11 days. 2 days before hatching, the egg color changes to light brown with a blue point at one end of the egg. This stage is called head pigmentation or pinhead stage. On the next day, the egg color changes to blue and the stage is called body pigmentation or blue egg stage. The incubation of silkworm eggs can be studied under the following headings. Number 1. Types or methods of incubation. Number 2. Devices for incubation. Number 3. Factors associated with incubation. Number 4. Methods of block boxing. And finally, number 5th. Incubation environment on volcanism. Incubation of silkworm eggs is of two types, namely constant temperature incubation and rise temperature incubation. First one is constant temperature incubation. In this method, incubation is carried out till hatching at a constant temperature of 25 to 26 degree centigrade. This method is adopted for acid-treated and non-hibernating eggs. Second one is rise temperature incubation. This method is used for incubating hibernating eggs. In this, soon after the release of eggs from cold storage, they are preserved at 10 to 15 degree centigrade for 3 days, 18 to 20 degree centigrade for 2 days, 23 to 24 degree centigrade for 4 days, and 23 to 26 degree centigrade till hatching. This method avoids sudden violent shock to delicate embryo in the silkworm eggs, which are previously exposed to temperatures from 2.5 degree centigrade to 25 degree centigrade. The method is helpful in uniform development of the embryo. Incubation may be undertaken individually or collectively. It would be ideal to undertake incubation in incubation centers. Such centers exist in China and Japan, but in India, the devices used for incubation of silkworm eggs are as follows. The first device is incubation chamber. The incubation chamber is made of an iron sheet with a double layered wall. Water can be poured into the space between the two layered walls to maintain the humidity. It has a ventilator on top and an electric heater or coal furnace at the bottom to maintain the optimum temperature. This method of chamber is used in China. In India, an attempt has been made to design an auto-controlled incubation chamber, which is a double-walled metallic box with insulating materials between the walls, provided with exhaust fan and heater with a thermostat control. The second device is tray. The eggs can be incubated in wooden or plastic trays by providing paraffin paper and wet foam pads. During rainy season, the egg sheets are spread in the trays without using wet foam pads. To maintain optimum temperature, room should be heated up using an electric heater or a charcoal stove. The third device is room. In places where cold storages are available, exclusive incubation rooms are constructed. These rooms have provisions of maintaining optimum temperature and humidity, besides having provisions for regulating the photoperiod. It is important that incubation rooms should not be overcrowded with silkworm eggs, as it increases the carbon dioxide content of the room. The fourth device is earthen flower pot. For this, an earthen flower pot with mouth diameter of about 15 inch is used. The pot is filled up with 2 to 3 inch thick layer of clean sand, which is kept wet. The pot is provided with a row of holes for about 1/2 inch diameter at 2 to 3 inch above the sand level. The egg sheets are tied to a rod and are hung inside. Loose eggs in boxes are piled up on a base stand. In incubation of both types of eggs, the pot is covered with a clean wet cloth. The fifth device is buried earthen pot. Round earthen pot of 20 to 25 liter capacity with a wide mouth is buried up to neck level in clean wet sand can be used. Sand is kept wet one day prior to incubation for preconditioning. The eggs in sheets are tied to a rod and hung inside the pot. The loose eggs in boxes can be piled up on a base stand. The pot is covered with a clean wet cloth. Periodical wetting of sand or cloth should be maintained. This method provides optimum temperature and humidity. The pot accommodates up to 300 layings and is suitable for individual farmers. The method is highly effective in dry and high temperature areas. The pot can also be used for the preservation of the tender mulberry leaves for feeding engaged silkworms. The sixth device is double brick walled chamber. The chamber with double walls is constructed using burnt mud or cement bricks and cement mortar. The two walls are 3 inch apart and the space between the two is filled with clean sand loosely. While constructing, wire mesh shutter may be fixed to the mouth of the chamber to avoid rodent and predators entering it. The standard size of the outer wall is 6 feet by 4 feet by 3 feet and the inner one is 4 feet by 2 feet by 3 feet. The chamber accommodates 5000 to 6000 disease free layings and is found suitable for big farmers and chaki rearing centers and grainages. For incubation, egg sheets are tied to a rod with a sufficient gap between them and are hung in the chamber. The chamber can also be used for loose egg incubation. Periodical wetting of sand by water helps maintaining the required temperature and humidity. Eggs incubated in this device hatch uniformly. The larvae are healthy and grow better. The seventh device is low-cost incubation chamber. A simple, electricity independent and easy to handle low-cost incubation chamber is found efficient in providing conducive conditions for the growth of silkworm embryo during incubation of eggs. Low-cost incubation chamber is made up of clay and consists of two chambers, namely outer and inner. The outer chamber is 18 inch in height, 21 inch in diameter at the top and 15 inch diameter at the bottom. The inner chamber is 18 inch in height and 15 inch diameter at the top, opened end that tapers to 12 inch at the closed bottom end. The walls of both the chambers are provided with 0.2 inch diameter holes in rows of longitudinal pattern on top half of the chambers. Cleaned and formalin disinfected sand bed of 1 inch depth is prepared at the bottom of both the chambers. Sand in the chambers is kept sufficiently moist and conditioned at least 12 hours before keeping the eggs for incubation. The egg sheets are aligned vertically with the help of thin bamboo strips with enough space for air between them, and the mouth of both the chambers is provided with loosely knit wet gunny cloth. The eggs are incubated till they are ready for block boxing. The device is found very effective as it ensures optimum conditions for the effective development of silkworm embryo, leading to satisfactory hatching. The main factors associated with incubation of silkworm eggs are as follows. The first factor is transportation of eggs. Irregularities in hatching and subsequent cocoon crop losses can also be attributed to improper transportation methods. Extreme environmental conditions such as high temperature coupled with low humidity and oxygen deficiency during the course of transportation are harmful. Therefore, care should be taken to provide optimum incubation conditions during transportation. It is advisable to transport silkworm eggs during early developmental stages at the time when temperature fluctuation is less, that is during early morning or late evening hours, using transportation boxes fabricated for the purpose. The second factor is surface sterilization of eggs. Rearing room and equipments where incubation has to be carried out should be thoroughly disinfected prior to commencement of incubation. Silkworm eggs should be surface sterilized with 2% formalin for 10 minutes before and after cold storage of eggs. The third factor is temperature. It is one of the most important factors that play a vital role during incubation. Although the embryonic development takes place between 10 to 30 degrees centigrade, it will not be uniform at all temperatures in this range, and irregular hatching would result in. An optimum temperature of 25 plus or minus 1 degree centigrade is found ideal for incubation. Any deviation from the optimum temperature during incubation affects the embryonic development. Temperature in excess of 30 degree centigrade is highly deleterious, as hatching is significantly affected at 33 degree centigrade, where it is almost negligible. The fourth factor is relative humidity. It is an important factor as it directly affects the physiology of silkworm eggs. A relative humidity of 75% ± 5% is ideal for normal embryonic development. When it is less than 60%, it results in loss of water from the eggs. Humidity in excess of 90% leads to retention of physiological waste water in the eggs, which proves to be toxic to embryos. Further, humidity in combination with the temperature has profound influence on the developmental physiology of the egg. Though a temperature of 25 plus or minus 1 degree centigrade is ideal for incubation, the same becomes deleterious for the development of eggs if humidity is as low as 30% ± 5%. It not only affects hatching but also prolongs the incubation period and retards embryonic growth. Low humidity during pinhead and blue egg stages renders the gluey substance that surrounds the eggs to become too hard, and the larvae find it difficult to bite the egg shell, leading to failure of egg hatching. A combination of high temperature and low humidity results in desiccation of eggs and a majority of the eggs fail to hatch. The fifth factor is photoperiod. It has a direct effect on the volatilism in the bivoltines. Bivoltine silkworm eggs should be incubated at 16 hours light and 8 hours darkness to maintain the diapausing nature in the causing generation, in the ensuing generations. The intensity of light should be 0.1 watt or above. In case of low temperature incubation, the eggs are kept in darkness throughout the day, or the light conditions per day should not exceed 12 hours. If eggs are allowed to remain under light conditions throughout the day, the hatching will not be uniform. In order to obtain maximum hatching within a short period, the eggs during eye spot stage are kept in darkness. On the day of hatching, they are exposed to diffused light of moderate intensity. The sixth factor is aeration. As the eggs undergoing incubation respire vigorously, the room should be kept well aerated so that there is no hindrance for effective respiration. Aeration, especially from the middle part of the incubation period, plays a very important role. Good ventilation in the incubation room facilitates good circulation of air, which helps in driving out the poisonous gases produced due to metabolic activity in silkworm eggs. It is established that carbon dioxide level in excess of 0.3% is deleterious and kills the developing eggs. Therefore, incubation room should be properly ventilated or aerated. The seventh factor is duration of incubation. The duration of incubation is different for multivoltines, bivoltines, as also for chilled and hibernated eggs. It also varies with physical environmental conditions maintained during incubation. Incubation temperature and relative humidity for chilled and hibernated eggs is 25 plus or minus 1 degree centigrade and 75 plus or minus 5% respectively. Though schedule of reservation of silkworm eggs differs and incubation temperature and humidity have remained similar, there is variation in incubation duration with regard to bivoltines. The eighth factor is black boxing. Black boxing is a technique which involves confinement of the eggs to total darkness, that is scotophase. It provides synchronized hatching of eggs in a short period of time. In order to ensure synchronized hatching in a short span of time, photoperiod, that is photophase, is manipulated during the later stage of egg development, especially at the time when egg development reaches pinhead or egg pigmentation stage. After 48 hours of black boxing, the eggs are exposed to light. This procedure is based on the fact that egg development takes place under the light condition up to pinhead stage, and darkness facilitates uniform development thereafter up to onset of hatching. It has two advantages: to force the embryos which are lagging in their development to accelerate their development and join their developed counterparts. Silkworm egg being photosensitive in nature, darkness largely inhibits its hatching. Different methods adopted for black boxing of silkworm eggs are as follows. The first one is dark room method. In this method, the entire room where silkworm eggs are incubated is kept dark by switching off the lights when eggs reach the pinhead stage and exposed to light after 48 hours. The second one is incubator method. It involves incubation of layings in total darkness in incubators when they reach pinhead stage. The third one is block cloth method. In this method, the layings kept in trays for incubation are covered with double layered block cloth when developing embryos reach pinnate stage and exposed to light after 48 hours. The fourth one is wooden box method. The method involves the use of a wooden box block painted on inner side for incubation. Eggs after reaching pinnate stage are kept in these boxes and exposed to light after 48 hours. The fifth one is block paper bag method. In this method, the layings are kept in block paper bag in pinnate stage and are exposed to light after 48 hours. Stage of block boxing. Silkworm eggs should be block boxed when at least of 80% of eggs have reached the pinnate stage. Block boxing of eggs at blue egg or body pigmentation stage is not ideal as light stimulus would have already received by the brain cells of embryos. As a result, hatching will be initiated inside the block box itself. Pinnate stage appears mostly on the 7th day in multivoltine breeds and on the 8th day in bivoltine breeds under optimum incubation conditions. Light exposure to stimulate hatching. A photo period of 16 hours light and 8 hours darkness during incubation up to pinnate stage and then shifting to darkness for 48 hours followed by sudden exposure to light enable uniform hatching. Hatching occurs in 2 to 3 hours after exposure to electric light or natural diffused light, which is usually done around 7 a.m. A relative humidity of about 75% is ideal at the time of hatching. The major environmental factors influencing volcanism of silkworm race or breed are number 1 temperature, number 2 photo period, number 3 relative humidity. The first factor is temperature. Temperature during incubation has greatest influence on volcanism. In other words, it plays an important role in determining whether bivoltine silkworms will lay hibernating or non-hibernating eggs. When bivoltine silkworm eggs are incubated at a temperature of 25 degree centigrade or above, the resulting moss will lay hibernating eggs. However, the incubation of eggs at a low temperature of 15 degree centigrade, it results in production of non-hibernating eggs regardless of environmental conditions during larval and pupal stages. An intermediate temperature of 20 degree centigrade during incubation will result in production of both hibernating and non-hibernating eggs. The second factor is photoperiod. Photoperiod during incubation also influences volcanism, but the effect is not evident if temperature is above 25 degree centigrade or below 15 degree centigrade. At the intermediate temperature, if long photoperiod is provided to the developing embryos, the resulting moss will lay more number of hibernating eggs. By contrast, the short photoperiod induces production of more non-hibernating eggs. It is established that the influence of light is next only to temperature. The third factor is relative humidity. The influence of relative humidity on volcanism is next only to light. It does not affect volcanism if incubation temperature is above 25 degree centigrade or below 15 degree centigrade. At an intermediate incubation temperature, high humidity is favorable for production of more hibernating eggs, while low humidity for non-hibernating eggs. Temperature, photoperiod and relative humidity affect the volcanism of silkworm at stages when embryo begins to form the thoracic legs and when the head begins to be pigmented. The basic requirement for the bivoltine silkworm to lay hibernating eggs is the temperature above 25 degree centigrade. If eggs are incubated at a temperature below 15 degree centigrade and kept in dark and dry conditions, most bivoltine races may produce non-hibernating eggs. Incubation of silkworm eggs has profound influence on the embryonic development, egg hatchability, robustness of the larvae, cocoon crop, performance, and voltinism. Therefore, appropriate incubation devices or methods need to be used for maintaining optimum temperature, relative humidity, and photoperiod to realize maximum potential of a race or a breed in terms of cocoon production and cocoon quality on a sustainable basis.